These Google Sheets shortcuts will help you save up to 70% of your time on boring tasks, and they are frequently used in daily routine. So let's get started. Suppose that we want to apply this date format to all of these dates here. Instead of manually doing this, let's try this shortcut. Select the cell containing the desired date format and then click this paint format icon. Now keep holding your left mouse click and drag it down like this to apply this format to all of the remaining cells. I am on row number 1000 in my Google Sheets, and instead of scrolling all the way up using my mouse wheel or using this scroll bar, let's try this shortcut. Click anywhere in any cell of the sheet and press Control Home to quickly move to the start of the sheet. Now I want to add a new entry to the end of this table. And if I scroll like this, it will take a lot of time, especially when the table contains thousands of rows. So here is a quick shortcut. Select the first cell in your table and hit Control down arrow to quickly jump to the end of the table. And I can start adding new entry here. Similarly, use Control up arrow to quickly jump back to the start of the table. And the same logic can be applied with Control right arrow to jump horizontally between the tables and Control left arrow to move back. These shortcut keys will save you a lot of time, especially when you are working with large data sets. These selection shortcuts are even more important than the navigation shortcuts we just discussed. Suppose that we want to change the format of all these sales number into a currency format. Never select the cells again like this. Let me show you a quick shortcut. Select the first cell here and then press Control Shift and right arrow to select all the adjacent cells. And then I'm gonna press Control Shift and down arrow to select all the cells in the range. And if you have the blanks just like we have here, press Control Shift down arrow twice to select the remaining range. Then I'm gonna press Control Shift and 4 to convert them all into a currency format. Manually adding columns like this in Google Sheets is a waste of time, especially when you want to add multiple columns. Try this shortcut. If you are inside a table or a range, use the shortcut key Control and space 2 times to select the column. Alternatively, select any cell outside the range and then press Control space key to select the column. Then use the shortcut key Control Alt and plus sign to add a column. And keep pressing the plus sign multiple times to add more columns. Similarly, use Ctrl Alt minus sign to delete the columns. And the same can be done with the rows. The shortcut key to select the row is Shift and Space key. After selecting the row, use Ctrl Alt plus to add and Ctrl Alt minus to delete the rows. You may have noticed that the data is overflowing these cells. So we want to resize all these columns. Simply select all the columns like this and move your cursor between any of the two columns. And once you see these two arrows, double click to resize them all. The shortcut key to add sheet is Shift F11. And if you keep pressing Shift F11, it will continue adding new sheets. Now that we have multiple sheets, manually switching between them is time consuming. Use the shortcut key Control Alt page down to move forward between the tabs and Control Alt page up to move backwards between the tabs. And sometimes you want to switch to a specific sheet, but if you are working with, for example, 50 plus sheets, it will be inefficient to use Control Alt page up or page down to switch to your desired sheet. So here is another quick shortcut. Press Ctrl K on any cell in any sheet. Then click this sheet and name ranges. Choose the sheet you want to switch to and hit enter. Now hover over the sheet and click this link to quickly move to the desired sheet. We want to change the month of these dates from June to July. Press Ctrl H and then write what you want to find and what you want to replace it with. Then select the specific range and click here. And then select the relevant column or the relevant range, just like this. Click OK and then click Replace All. And it will replace all the dates containing June to July. This and the next two shortcuts are highly important, and they are frequently used by the Excel and Google Sheets users of all types. We want to total the sales of all these regions, so let's apply some formula in the first cell here. I will press equal sign and then I will write sum, open the parentheses, and then I will select this range. And watch what happens when I close the parentheses and hit enter. Google Sheets will suggest me to autofill the entire range with the same formula. And this is exactly what we want to do. So I will hit control and enter to automatically apply this formula to all of the remaining cells. You will frequently face a situation where you want to analyze specific data, and that's where the sort and filter features comes into play. Let's apply filter to this table. Select the first header cell, press Ctrl, Shift and right arrow, then Ctrl, Shift, down arrow to select the entire range. And now I will use the shortcut key Alt, D and F to apply the filter. And then I will press Ctrl Home to jump back to the start of the sheet. And now we can easily filter the data. For example, let's filter the sales of product ID 1005. Click the filter sign here, then click clear, and then search 1005, then select this, hit OK, and now it will show the sales of product ID 1005 only. Similarly, we can filter by a specific condition as well. Let's select the greater than here and I will write 10,000 and click OK. And now it will filter the sales that are greater than $10,000 for the North region. Likewise, we can sort this data as well. For example, let's sort the sales according to the product ID. Click the filter and then choose sort A to Z, and the entire table will be sorted according to the product ID. Now let's discuss the conditional formatting. The shortcut key to apply conditional formatting is Alt, O and F. And here we can apply our rules. Let's color the sales that are less than $10,000 with a red color. Click here to select the range and I will choose this range here. Just like that. And click OK. And now let's add a rule. Click here the format rules. I will choose less than. Then I will write 10,000. And I will choose the light red color here. Click done. And all of the sales values that are less than $10,000 are filled with the red color. And finally, let's discuss a couple of more shortcuts before wrapping up this video, which you will also find very useful. I'm scrolling this table and you may notice that I cannot see the header, which is very annoying because I cannot figure out which data I'm looking at. To fix this problem, let's grab this gray horizontal bar and drag it just below my header and release it. And now when I scroll, the header is fixed in a place, so I can easily see what data I'm looking at. Here, the text is not quite filling in the cells, so we want to wrap this text. The shortcut key to wrap the text is Alt O W W, and it will wrap the text in the cells so you can easily see what's written. And that's all about this video. If you find it useful, please like and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to comment if you have any problems. I will see you in the next video.